Hello guys, and welcome back to the Thermal Mods series. In this episode, we'll talk about fluids, mostly about water actually, and we'll talk about items and blocks that are very much related to water. We'll also go into thermal cultivation, because the watering can is, at the time of recording, it's the only item in thermal cultivation, so I think it suits well in this episode. So, as you might remember from the previous video, we talked about the steam dynamo. It requires water, and now I'll show how to automatically create and feed water into it. And we do that with another type of duct. You remember the flux duct and the item duct from before? The third type of duct, and you use and place them and pick them up in the exact same way, it's the Fluiduct. So it's a very straightforward block to use. Use your crescent hammer to disable and or pick up for that matter. And when you connect it to a machine that supports fluid transfer, it will automatically connect. So that's very straightforward. You can also use the multimeter to track how much water or fluid actually is are being transported. Now, there are of course different Fluiducts. This is the normal one, and there are Signalum-Plated, Super-Laminar. They have, they have their own uniqueness, but basically the better tier, the higher transfer rate. But there are also some other differences. The most important is perhaps that if you transfer lava through Fluiducts, it will break. So you will need a hardened fluid duct for lava and hot and very cold fluids. But use a tooltip to see what you need. Contents may be any temperature, it's the hardened. That's about transport, and let's go into creation, because well, we'll use that very shortly. You can actually create water out of from two other sources, just like you do with a normal water source, like this. You have an infinite water source in the middle. And Accu's accumulator can use this feature. So the only thing you need to do is to place water on at least two sides of the accumulator. So, and when you do that, the accumulator will start to produce water, and you can output it at in any direction that you would like. I don't know if the front, but anyway. And you can connect your Fluiducts, and everything is very straightforward. So when you have it placed down and surrounded with water, I just have two sides covered with water, but you can have up to six actually. Now this one is configured to only work on high signal. So let's give it a high signal and see what happens. We have the top configured as an output, and sure enough, we'll get some water up there. So you can place this with some water sources, and then you just connect the Fluiducts to all your steam dynamos, and they will have all the water they need. So it's very easy to use and very, very straightforward as well. Now I'm only pumping the water into a portable tank. So let's talk a little bit about that before moving on. This is a quite simple thing to build. We need to portable some glass, copper, and redstone iron. And this one is also upgradable, so you can see it says basic, and if you upgrade to resonant, I think it's like 60 or 80 buckets of water instead of just 20. You can actually also use the multimeter. Just like we can normally measure things, we can also right-click just to see the status, like this, 16 buckets. But you can also shift right-click it, and then you open up this GUI where we can enable or disable output, or we can lock it to a certain type of fluid. So even if this one is totally empty, it will now be locked to water, and even if I try to insert something else, nothing will happen. So that's very, very convenient, which means that you can use the same Fluiduct for different types of fluids. Another good thing is that when you break it and pick it up, shift right click, it will retain its water. And also the configuration. And when we place it back again, it will look exactly the same as before. You can also use a red print to have pre-configured size, so we can place lots of them down and we'll have the same configuration. All right. So now I'm with the portable tank out of the way and or up here. We can actually use it a bit more. You can see it has a blue downside. This is the place where it will output. So if I connect a pipe here, I can right click here to change between output or input. So we can, and here's a servo. I can also extract on the sides. It doesn't need to be on the bottom. So let's, and this one is configured just to be enabled on high signal. Now you can see that the water is being transferred over to this one. And nothing will happen because this is an input right now. But if I change this to an output, I can do it with a wrench or with my multimeter. Then you can see it is dumped down into this one. Right-clicking is exactly the same thing. But it doesn't have to be going down as well. Just from, like with the side, we can, oops, let's switch places on these ones. We can also output on the top, high signal required, and this one, well, this one needs to be in insert mode, of course. So yes, click right that, and it will fill. Okay, so now we got some rain, and then I can actually mention that the accumulator should be able to collect water when it's raining. At the moment, it's not working for me. I don't know why exactly. I'll update the video description if I find out. But yeah, rain can also fill it. It's a lot slower than with the water source blocks, but well, at least you know about it. And with that, let's move into our final item from cultivation, as I said. The watering can comes in 5 tiers. You can see it comes from a copper hardened, reinforced, signalum or resonant. They are not upgradable with the upgrade kits, but you will use the basic one to craft the hardened one, and in turn of like every step. And this is a very, very powerful item. I will demonstrate it. Let's start by filling it. And I want to be in survival. Yeah, I want to be in survival mode for this, because I can right click up here on the tank and it will be filled up. I'm using the water from here. You see, it wasn't completely empty before. And let's see if we can take. Yeah. You can also fill it from a source block, but make sure you shift right click to do that. And now you can see we have 9 buckets. But what do you use it for? Well, of course, you water your plants and your crops. So I'll show how that looks here. And different tiers. So the basic one, the copper one, I call it, has an area of 3x3. And then the hardened one has a 5x5 and so on up to 11x11. And, well, not much will happen when I just water like this. We need to place down some seeds, and we need to hoe around here. Ah, the basic one. And we can place our seeds, and we can then continue to water to keep the farmland hydrated. and also make the crops grow much faster. So just by holding my right mouse button, these are growing like crazy. But now my water is empty, only 4 buckets, so it wasn't too much. But as you can see, I can actually grow crops without any water source block. So we can shift, right click here, and then we can continue. And that takes us to the next tier. You can see 5x5, but we don't have to do that. We don't have to water 5x5. We can actually press V, the standard button, to water 3x3 only. Or 5x5. But other than that, they work exactly the same. The water consumption is a bit different, because if I water a big area, I will consume more water from it, of course. But I don't have to use the full size, so to say. And then step by step, we'll take it. Perfect. Up to the maximum size. And pressing V, you can see here, area 7x7, 9x9. Eleven by 11. So this is a huge area, and I think a good idea could be to have a water block in the center anyway. Then you can just run around, grow your crops, harvest. The only thing you need is water. Okay, so I think that's pretty much everything I have time to cover in this episode. Actually, I learned a few new things myself when preparing this, like using the multimeter on a portable tank and a few details about the accumulator. If I forgot on anything important, I'll post it in the video description, and so yeah, remember to check that. Yeah, so that's about it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Take care and bye-bye.